Oh.
Yeah.
Not on her. Thank you. Let's go. The safe must be in another box under the sink. Okay, I got lots of home, if not. You're going to my place up here, I got lots of home. She went to the store for cigarettes.
Thank you.
Well, first off, I'd like to thank everyone for coming to that funeral. We wouldn't be here without him, and he would be really happy to see all of you here today. I'm sure it's melting his heart right now as he sits in the afterlife. Seeing all of you makes it easier to heal a little bit, so that's helpful. Thank you guys. I'd like to invite anyone who wants to speak a few words about my dad if they feel comfortable enough in sharing to come on up if they want to. Okay. I guess we'll start the tribute video. Oh, you want to? Okay, come on in.
I'd just like to say that I'm very grateful for the last memory I had with him.
That was good.
Laughed, and it was good. Honestly, I thought I was going to get to see him another time, but I just focus on, you know, that. That I got to see him laugh and smile, and it was with me, you know? So, that's.
Okay, thank you, Keisha. As we remember Dad's life, I want you to know we all had long conversations of his passing. He wanted more than anything for us to all be okay and to stay strong. So that's what I've been trying to do. It is extremely hard, especially because we talked almost every day. I thought I was prepared. But it all just happened so suddenly. So I'm going to read a letter that I wrote him while he was in the hospital a few months before he passed. But first, I'd like to start the tribute video.
Thank you.
Best daddy ever. You mean the world to me. I extremely miss you and love you. Watching your health decrease has been hard, and I wouldn't have it any other way, because I love being here for you. I've always got your back and always will. Nothing could change that. I feel as though I failed you in a sense, and in many ways. I'm so sorry for that, but I do love you and want to be here for you. I just want you to know and truly understand that I'm not going anywhere. I'm always here for you, just a call or text away, and you make me strong. I'm proud to be your daughter. You're an amazing dad, grandfather, person, husband, and amazing friend as well. I never thought we would ever get this close, but look where we are today. I cherish that and all of our memories we have together. I miss our movie days together, just hanging out, blazing, and making memories with my kids, who will always remember you and cherish you as well. They will always love you and be able to reminisce about you together with me, even when I'm old, an old grandmother. My only regret is not being able to know Grandma better. She is an amazing woman. You turned out better in the end than most try in their whole life. I want to thank you for putting in the efforts you have for me and my family like no one else has. You have shown my kids that they are loved, not just by mom and dad, but by a grandpa that's loving and has tickle bugs. No one has tickle bugs like grandpa. The moments I get with you, every time making amazing memories that always treasure. Hopefully, if you're feeling better by the summer, then we can take a road trip to see my brother, your son, Brad. That would be killer. I've been going mad not being able to hang out like we used to. I'm so incredibly and honestly, I have not been able to visit. I'm glad my truck's running now so I can come see you. I hope this letter brings you a smile. I could only imagine how intense and frustrating it is to be cooped up in the hospital for so long, being jerked around and not knowing what's going to happen. You're so strong. You're my role model, my best friend. You're on my mind constantly. We are praying for you to get better. I must remind you that and make you understand and know that I'm here anytime you need me. And I love you extremely. You make me proud with the resilience and strongness you show daily. You have been through a lot in your life, and you're very strong-headed with everything you've been through. You have shown me how to be the woman I am, the woman I want to become, and I want to be, and remind you how strong I am. So I stand strong today. So I try to stay positive yet realistic about your health, but I know it's going to hurt to have you gone. I know you'll always be with me, but when you go from this realm, so will a piece of me in my heart. You are loved and always will be. My boys are excited to carry on your name, and it makes me proud. I love you, Dad. Please try not to be too negative, because I'm sure it's easy to get caught up in your head. Just remember, you're not alone. I'm a call away, 10-minute drive. I hope that they can get you somewhere nice. because you deserve to be happy. I adore seeing you laugh and you smile. I can't wait to see it again. My favorite sound is to hear you laugh. Keep your head up, smile, stay positive, and try not to go to stir crazy. I'll take you for a drive anytime I can. Mom wants to come see you, and I'll keep in touch more. Please, because not knowing what's going on drives me nuts. I worry about you daily, but wouldn't have it any other way, Dad. I love you always and forever. Your loving daughter, Kelsey. P.S. The boys say they love you. T.P.S. I had a dream last night of me, you, and a deed, and I thought it was weird. You left. You left with a deed. And begged me to do everything I could to hold our family together. She loves you. And so I want to conclude. This ceremony and celebration of his life with another thank you for showing up and loving my dad, or our dad. He was extremely, extremely heartfelt by that. When my dad passed away in the hospital that very day, I told him multiple times that it's okay to let go. And we will all be okay. I kept my promise to him to look after Mom, and I always will. I hope you're proud of me, Dad, with all my heart. And how I've done with all of this. We love you, Dad. Goodbye for now. Until we meet again in the afterlife. Thank you. So, should the team or now gonna come and help us grow up the casket?
Yeah. So we call it.